So I'm ready to start finishing the drywall. And the first step is to pre-fill. Any large holes or gaps that are in the drywall need to be, or should be filled in. And I've taped and mudded twice before this, so I know a little bit about it, but I've never pre-filled. And basically what you wanna do is fill in the big holes, because regular joint compound is already mixed in a bucket and it dries by evaporation, so it actually shrinks when it dries. So you don't want to put it on thick or fill in any large gaps with it. If you do that, it'll shrink and usually crack on you. So what you want to do for the larger holes is use drywall mud that's not already pre-mixed. So this stuff will actually, you mix it with water and it dries by a chemical reaction. And it's a lot stronger. It actually dries like concrete, and you can't really sand it. So that's good to fill in the large holes, give you a good surface, and then you put the regular taping mud over that. So the bag says easy sand, but it's definitely not as easy to sand as the other stuff. I'm sure you can still sand it, but I'm gonna try to put it on in a way that it doesn't need to be sanded. And then the 90 is how many minutes you have till it hardens. Whereas with the pre-mixed stuff, that's determined by the humidity in the room, you know, how thick you put it on, the temperature, all that kind of stuff. This is just gonna dry at a set time. So they make like 5 minute mud, 20 minute mud, I don't know, 45 minute mud. This is one of the longer ones, just so, you know, I'm not a pro at this, so I can take my time a little bit more and not worry about it setting up on me. Now there is one interesting area. If you're not familiar with how drywall is, you can see on these two sheets that along the long edge only, there's a bevel. And you can actually see from the shadow coming down that right here the sheet indents and comes back out. And that's so you can put the tape across the joint, do a second coat, fill it in, and you're actually filling in this indent, and then you'll have a smooth wall. Whereas with these butt joints, there is no indent, so you're actually building it up and then feathering it out. So over here we had a problem with this wall because I tied into this existing wall and that was all just a butt joint along the edge. It was all just flat. So when I put this sheet on, this was a butt joint and this is a bevel joint, which I guess I could have either done it vertically and cut off the end, or I could have done it a little differently, but the way it turned out is up here, can't really see it. You can see the bevels right here. So there's actually a bevel here. So this is flat. This is not. This is lower than this. So my fingers actually hit that. I tried to cut that back a little bit. But when I go to tape this, the tape needs to go right here. And there's not a flat surface for the tape to go on. So what I need to do is fill in this bevel with pre-fill. So this whole thing is flat. And then once it dries, we could tape over top of that. Had another kind of dumb problem in this corner. These two sheets, I was able to hang horizontally. The only problem was they were an inch short. So I filled in the end of this with just a piece of scrap. But when I filled it in with the scrap, I used a beveled edge, which I shouldn't have done. I should have used a non-beveled edge. So it's actually lower than the rest of that. So when I go to tape that, it's not gonna have a good surface there. So I just need to fill in this this piece so that it's at the same level as everything else.
on this board here, if you can get it up, wait, and we'll slide it down. Okay. It's not on my side, just push it on your side. Okay. Now slide it.
So on the back side of the bar here, there's going to be a lower countertop right at this line. So the countertop guys need to come out and measure for a top counter and then for the lower section. So before they can come measure, we first need to build this so that they could take accurate measurements. There's going to be a sink on that end, and then it's actually going to end right about here, and there's going to be a kegerator thing right here. Alright, so I'm about halfway done mudding. Took off the railing here. We did all kinds of stuff. I'll show you everything. So everything's taped. Got a second coat on some of these seams. These corner beads, which I just sanded. All these edges here, they're all second coated. So that just needs one more coat on it. And then all these angles. When you do the corners, you can't do both sides of a corner. So you can tape them at the same time, but you can't. You just do one more coat over the tape, and you have to do one side at a time. So as you can see, my left side is done, right side is not. And then this will just get sanded a little bit. But then same thing up at the top. I did this one, and this one, and then I'll come back and do the opposite ones once it's dry. But yeah, a lot of these, pretty much every seam that's not on the ceiling is second coated. So the bathroom is all second coated. Had some water coming from the other side of the wall there. So tomorrow I'd like to get this final coat and then prime it, because we have actually flooring that was ordered coming tomorrow that we can install here, so that'll be in the next episode. Texted the guy today to see if he could build this built-in thing. You can see all the ceiling nice and taped. I only have the tape coat on now, and I did parts of the second coat. I did all the butt joints second coat today, or what they call the fill coat, I guess. So tomorrow I'll do the long ones, and then this TV nook, again, I got half of the corners. I'll do the other half tomorrow, get that finished up. But you know, these bevel joints, because these are the easier ones to do, they feel super flat. Like, I sanded this and it's perfectly flat, so I just did the tape coat and the second coat, and that doesn't need any more. The screw holes are pretty good. This got primed today. I got all three coats in here, and it's 100% good to go. I guess we'll put a coat of actual paint in here, and then use this as storage. So you'll come in to the left, and there will be some shelves in here. So everything else is looking good. Column, I have. That's looking good with the corner beads on it. I'll get the third coat on there. I'll start that tomorrow. This part you just like fill in, basically. But you can see how much it's feathered out pretty much to the middle with each of them. So it's gonna pretty much fill that in with mud. You can see the top. tall seams are still wet. I did those this morning. The bar is primed. All three coats are done on that. Guys came out today. I guess we already bought the countertop. We already paid for it. The guys came out today and measured for it. It's going to be granite. It's like a grayish white granite with a bunch of black specks in it, because the walls down here are going to be gray. So that actually, 1 week from today, they'll deliver that. So, and then on the back side is the lower portion. So another same kind of countertop. And then once they're both in, we'll do tiles back on this little section. This is the bay for the kegerator, which is right here. We unpacked it and made sure it fit, and it plugs in right in the back. And got some lights under here, so it actually lights up this whole underside real nice. And then once the countertops are in, we'll find a way to dress up the back of this, probably put some plywood on there and make the openings a little smaller. There's our sink that's going to go right here. We have to move this light. The pump was hooked up, but we unhooked it because we're going to paint under here. But we ran it a couple times. It works good. That's it right there. And then back here is the countertops that, or the counters that we have up sitting in the garage. We bought them. There's three counters and a mini fridge in the middle. That's the same height. And then I think it's not going to be granite, but a countertop will go over top of that. And then you can see everything else. So this is taking a lot longer than I thought. This is my spring break week. So today's Wednesday. My first day off was actually Friday. And almost every day, at least the last like 3 or 4 days, this is my fourth one, I think, I've been working the full day. It's 6 o'clock right now. I've been working since 8:30 when I woke up, and I did a 13-hour day the other day, just mudding and taping all by myself. So it's, well, my dad's doing things like building that. So it's, yeah, it's taking a while. So I'm hoping by the time I go back to school on Monday, it's pretty much done, ready for primer. And then back in the storage, this is all third coated. This is the first area I did. Didn't sand it yet, but this is the first area I did, so it doesn't look as good as the rest. But yeah, this whole thing is done. You have to sand all that. This is the dehumidifier. That's what was leaking under the wall there. We got all the drywall scraps except for these couple ones upstairs into the garage, and then every week we're putting some out with the trash. And then we hung these, this wall got primer, and then we hung these recycled cabinets that actually came from the place where me and my dad work. So we got some free cabinets. They're really big and heavy and heavy duty, so pretty nice. And then underneath them, room for storage. I don't know if we're gonna put shelves here or what, but it's pretty nice. Good bit of storage back here. So so, what is it today? Sunday night, and I got the mudding all done, finally. Worked every single day, I think like 9 days in a row over my spring break, and I finally got this done. Didn't finish sanding, I was too tired today. Sanded all the outside corners, so look how nice this looks. It's like perfect. And some of the inside corners. I didn't finish all these inside corners. You can still see there's some junk up there. That just needs chipped out and then just a light sanding, and it's perfect. I have to do all these inside corners up top. I took a nap today after I sanded for a little bit, and my dad attached the corbels. Like I said, it's Sunday night, and then during the day on Wednesday, they're going to deliver these granite counters. So you'll see that probably first thing in the next episode. this was a little easier than I thought. I was kind of stressed out about doing the mudding, but ceiling came out real nice. This is my first time doing a big project like this as far as mudding goes. I've done smaller projects, but yeah, this all needs, you can see it's rough up there. It needs a good sanding. We have a pole sander over there. So, but the TV nook, I have to do some patches too. There's a little patch I need to do there, a little one up there, I think. Yeah, you can see how rough the ceiling is without sanding. So when you do these butt joints, you're putting the tape and then going over the top of the tape, and then the next coat you're making a little wider, and then your next coat you're going a little wider than that, so they get pretty wide. And then these ones, you can see how that's a perfectly straight line. This is just filled in, so there's not a bump in the wall at all, whereas up here you got a good sized bump in the wall that we need to feather out pretty far. But yeah, real nice. Perfect corners and everything. This came out real good. Look up here. This is the reason this column is pretty wide. It didn't need to come out this far. I brought it out further than it needed to, specifically so that this transition would be flat. And you can tell just how nice that looks. It's perfectly flat up there. Perfectly straight. That column is exactly the same width, lines up perfectly with this one. Came out real nice. So, there's the vanity for the bathroom. I have a list going of things I need to patch. These real high ceilings are good. Look how nice all that looks. There's the transition I was a little worried about from the old to the new. Again, that needs sanded, but that'll be real nice when it's done. And the bathroom is primed. So it's primed. We have the flooring purchased. We have the paint purchased. Once we get time, this will get primer on the ceiling, paint. It's gonna be like a blue paint. And we have all this stuff right in here. Once we get the flooring trim done, get the sink and toilet in here, get the door on. This will be the first room to be done. All these corners here, this is where the old ties into the new. Right there. Got a little bit more to sand right there.